to the virtual Sunday service for the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship of Lake Norman. Our fellowship walks diverse paths to find meaning and purpose, but we are united by our belief in the inherent worth and dignity of all, as well as the obligation to express our faith through acts of justice and compassion. We are an open and inclusive liberal faith community. All are welcome, regardless of race, gender, sexual orientation, ability, or economic status. My name is Nancy Embry, and I've been an active member since 2015. Our flaming chalice is lit to illuminate the world we seek. In the search for truth, may we be just, and in justice, may we be loving. Pastor Reverend Pat Jobe has a message to share entitled, Imagine All the People. He takes this inspiration from John Lennon's song, Imagine, which came out 50 years ago in an album by the same name.
Before I get started, let me just say a little bit about our blessing of the animals on October 16th. This is a really big deal. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to be there from noon until 3 at Tractor Supply in Denver, North Carolina. My wife wanted to know if that was Denver, Colorado. No, baby. Denver, North Carolina. It'll be a lot of fun. We'll promote our congregation, the Dog Fence Ministry, and Autumn's Ministry to Children and Youth. We don't need volunteers, but we need you to come if you possibly can. And either bring your animals or just hang out with the great fun energy of the event. Yeehaw! Please let me know if you want to know more. And as always, invite your friends. As always, invite your friends. End of commercial. I hope by now you understand that I love you. I really do love you. I know for some of you that's a bit far-fetched. It's okay. Maybe it's like a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow, or a man in a little white suit traveling all over the world in a single night to deliver gifts to children. But it's true. I do love you. The Beatles famously sang, "All you need is love, and therefore I love you." I could go on and on about whom I love and how I love and the good that has come of it, but for now, as much as you can, right here, right now, understand that I love you. One quick story about how love can sometimes go wrong. When Gabriel and I were first dating, she was a little undone by the fact that I was so nice to my ex-wives. Two ex-wives are a bit problematic in any new relationship, but to add to that the layer of this guy is actually nice to his ex-wives, she didn't really connect with that. So one night, I carried the trash out for my most recent ex-wife, and it just flew all over David. But she's not the spitfire, cane-raisin kind of person, because she's done a lot of self-help work, and she's done a lot of conscious breathing. And so she didn't yell and scream at me. She just sort of froze up. And as we were driving home, I thought I would try to break the ice by saying, "I love you, Gabriel." And she said with clenched teeth, "You love a lot of people." Okay. John Lennon. He died at 40. In the 17 years between his death and he and the other three Beatles exploding into our psyche on the Ed Sullivan Show, they sold hundreds of millions of albums, tens of thousands of tickets to concerts and movies of their various cinematic projects. Just to give you one tiny example of their power to penetrate culture, John Lennon's Imagine has been hit 2 billion times on YouTube. That's a little less than 5 times the population of the United States, or it is a tremendous percentage, 2/7 of the population of the world. Listen to the words. Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us, above us only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no countries. It's hard. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. And no religion, too. Imagine all the people living in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us and the world will live as one. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger, a brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us. And the world will live as one. Yesterday was Lennon's 81st birthday. I dare say people will still be listening to his music on his 181st birthday, and maybe on his 281st birthday. He and Paul McCartney had an uncanny knack for writing songs and performing them, but that's not really what we came here to talk about today, is it? What does all this have to do with a UU congregation among Lake Norman communities? What do we imagine as we consider our own religion? Heaven and hell, national loyalty, or the owning of possessions? Lennon sounds as though he wants us to lay down anything that separates us into warring factions of differences, or our abilities to find enough to eat. It is wild idealism. But come on. Is such a thing even remotely possible? Are we not doomed by all our weaknesses to live in a world always tortured by greed, warfare, and hunger? I think I know how most of you would answer that question, and I don't blame you. Of course, we are just human. You probably would answer the way my father did when he was trying to talk me into being a little more realistic as a young fan of what we then called Woodstock Nation. He told me, on the day you die, wars will still be fought, children will still die of hunger, all the problems you think you and your hippie friends can solve will still be just as awful and horrible and terrible as they are now, on the day you die. Of course, that inspired me to inwardly say, I'll show you. I became a journalist and wrote about charitable work that helped battered women, poor people, hungry people. I wrote about church people who stood in defiance of the power structure and other idealists who spoke truth to power. And somewhere along the line, I heard John Lennon sing Imagine, and I heard that Albert Einstein said imagination is more important than knowledge. Well, is it? Is it? And if it is, does it have the power to upend the arms manufacturers who would rather sell death than end war? Does it have the power to end the illusions of separation that have so many of us sitting on piles of possessions while other people starve to death? I say yes. Yes. In answer to both these questions, but I confess it is a conditional yes. And you can hear the conditions in Lennon's refrain, words that are repeated twice as he sings the song. You may say, hey, I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us. The world will live as one. The dreamers are out there, and they are in this congregation. When we live as our best selves, we are joining Lennon's imagination. When we build a dog fence, or feed the homeless, or the food stressed at Feed NC. When we reach out through our social action to empower voters, and stand with Justice, UU Justice North Carolina, as we are taking down walls and building bridges among all kinds of dreamers. We know damn well that we are not the only ones. Someday the rest of the people who have heard that song will join us, and the world will live as one. Oh, really? Really? Well, there is a chance my sainted daddy was right. After all, I could drop dead this afternoon proving that he was right. But my plan is to keep on walking, keep on talking, keep on walking up to freedom's land. Sure, there are plenty of people on the other side who embrace an exclusive, hateful world where only the better people are well fed, have adequate health care, and are safe from bombs bursting in air, the rocket's red glare. And they don't have to worry about it. But let's imagine the more and more are joining us. Let's dare to think about friends we know who might just be ready to walk over. I really hope we recruit some new members as we Bless the Animals in Denver on October 16th. But I also know we are in for the long haul. If the world really is to live as one, if we really are to imagine such a beautiful world, it's going to take a little doing. Emerson predicted that within 200 years, the entire world would be Unitarian. That leaves us only about 50 years to rope the rest of them in. We better get busy. But so much more importantly is our using our imaginations to find those who will join us. Lennon may have warmed my heart most profoundly when he sang, "I hope someday you'll join us." Oh, yes, I do. Good people, caring people, people who are ready to join us. This isn't just about congregational growth, although it certainly can be. It should also be about standing up to power that insists on privilege, wrongs that need to be righted, injustice that needs to be rectified. The prophet Micah told us that all that is required is to do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly. Hard work sometimes, yes, but steady, steady work. Mostly staying with the effort until the work is done. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us and the world will live as one. Last week, you heard Amy Brooks Paradise challenge us to join the Day of Action in Charlotte, fully masked and socially distanced, to insist on climate justice. That's October 18th. If you want more information about it, get in touch with me. But even if you've already pushed those two dates, October 16th and October 18th, if you've already pushed them over into the dark corner of your brain where they go to die, please, please imagine all the people living in the world. Use your imagination, your wonderful human imagination, to become proximate, as Amy encouraged us last week. Become proximate, get close to the world that we live in now and the one John Lennon sang for us to imagine. Please, please, please. Imagine all the people living in the world. And use your wonderful imagination to get proximate to the world we live in now and the world John Lennon sang about.
Thank you, Pat, for your creative message. You've brought back some great memories and inspired us to go forward with fresh enthusiasm for the possibilities we can imagine becoming reality. And now let us enjoy a musical interlude with Teresa Woody.
Thank you.
Thank you, Teresa. You have added a lovely dimension to our service. And now for some announcements. If you are a visitor, welcome. We're so pleased you joined our virtual service. If you like what you've heard so far and are wondering how to stay connected or get involved with our congregation, please reach out to our membership chair, Linda. Her email address is visible at the bottom of the screen. We also have an active program for kids and teens that is inventive and engaging. Our teacher, Autumn, has gone virtual with the youth program, which this year is based on the spirit of Harry Potter. They have formed Dumbledore's Army and are fighting Horcruxes in our local community. These young folk are putting their creativity and love to work to make the world a better place. To get your young people involved, email Autumn at the following web address, re@uulakenorman.org. That's re@uulakenorman.org. In return, you will get activity kits and answers to your questions. Visitors, we encourage you to contact us and learn more about our kids and teens program. And members, staying connected with each other during these challenging times is important for our well-being. We encourage you to continue reaching out to one another whenever possible. Contacting other members by phone or email can really make a difference, and it certainly enriches the connections we have already fostered. Members, please note other announcements in our weekly newsletter, and a very special thanks to Regina for producing this newsletter every week. And now, let us go forth and live our lives with integrity.